Doma Sports Talk, worldwide, with some news from the world of boxing, so y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, we're going to go up to my heavyweights, but before, you know, Los Angeles Lakers for the NBA, they got, you know, your boy AD, Anthony Davis. Pretty good news, but I'm going to tell y'all something, them Pelicans going to be good too. I ain't going to get into that, I might do an extra video about that, what I think about that. But that's big news in the NBA. Listen, heavyweights, right? Something kind of important. You got Tyson Fury, who just come off his big win against Tom Schwartz. I don't know why I said big, but the win he was supposed to. But he got him out of there in two rounds, right? You know, it's rumored to be talking to Jarrell Miller for maybe a fight in the fall. Right. And we know Jarrell Miller. You know what happened with Jarrell Miller. It was supposed to be Anthony Joshua's opponent for June 1st. And he had everything in his system that you can possibly have in his system. And so the fact that he's being mentioned to fight Tyson Fury in the fall is irking his own promoter, which is Eddie Hearn, who is also the promoter of others. You know, Anthony Joshua is one of them. But Eddie Hearn is a little bit irked and irritated by the fact that they're already talking about a fight with Jarrell Miller. And his point is, it's all fresh. You know, it just happened 6 weeks ago. So why are we already talking about Jarrell Miller, right? Somebody who, like I said, had everything in his system. I mean, really, you know, EPO, we know what that does. Human growth hormone, you know, and this new GW 1516. Listen, that's everything, you know. And like Eddie Hearn was saying, that's blatant cheating. And if we're going to let people get blatant cheating, then why bother? With doping or even saying anything about it, right? Why? This is everything. You shouldn't be talking about a fight already, right? But like I told you guys before, I call it the Canelo syndrome. After Canelo Alvarez was able to dope, you know, with clenbuterol and say twice and say that it was the tainted meat, you can't give someone else more than 6 months for a while. It's going to take a while to be able to do that. Now, Canelo gets away with it. He's never been on the wrong side of a decision. They consider him the face of boxing, so things are going to go his way, period. That's what the boxing is going to do until people really get outraged and boycott, which they won't. So the bottom line is that Canelo got away with that with 6 months. Any lawyer or what representative of any fighter who gets caught is going to be saying that, okay? They're going to be saying that in the courtroom. Listen, you can't give this guy way more than Canelo got when we know obviously what happened. That's the problem right now. It's really simple as that. You know, Canelo was able to get away with saying it's tainted beef. You know, Tyson Fury, he's back doing his thing, right? He was able to say it was wild boar, right? So, you know, the people, they want to get away with things, are going to get away. So you can't, now we can't get upset about Jarrell Miller. Now, me personally, I would have gave Jarrell Miller 12 months. Because it's three different substances. And I wouldn't have gave more, but I would have gave him 12 months, at least a year, because of the way you were doing it, and it was blatantly, you were putting it in there, you know, just really, just you putting it in there, and you know you're putting it in there. It's not some substance, you know. You're taking a shot, basically. That's just blatant, and I understand that blatantly. And that's why he probably should have got 12 months, but not much more, unfortunately, unless everybody across the board gets treated the same way. Some people are not, and that's where the problem is in boxing. It's hypocritical, and that's where the problem is. But I do understand Eddie Hearn, and he's the promoter of Jarrell Miller. He could be talking something else. But he's like, if he's already talking about another fight, a big fight like that with Tyson Fury, then, you know, we might as well just leave the doping system alone. I agree with Eddie Hearn right here. I think they need to do something about it. But if it starts with the stars, if the stars are getting away with that, like Canelo Alvarez, right after that, right, his next fight, you know, because he only fights in May and September, the Mexican holidays, right? He's allowed to do that, first of all. So he missed the one on Cinco de Mayo and was right back in September, right? Didn't miss a beat, basically, right? And was right back and then was rewarded with the highest boxing deal in boxing history. I'm not saying for one fight, but a deal about $365 million for a 10 fight is a big deal, right? So that's what he was able to get after coming off a doping offense. Tyson Fury, ain't nobody even talking about his wild boar incidents or his cocaine or anything. Right? Call him the best boxer, all right, after fighting three guys who most hobby boxers could beat. Right? And drawing, coming off the floor against Wilder. He's by far the best heavyweight in some people's eyes. So it is what it is. But until we start at the top, it's never going to stop. Y'all feeling me? Doma Sports Talk. Worldwide. And I'm up out of here, y'all.